Hello students, today we will complete the subtopic structure of the respiratory system. In this subtopic, we were discussing about the organs of respiratory system. We have discussed nose, nasal cavity, pharynx, voice box and windpipe. Today we will discuss about bronchi, bronchioles and alveoli. We will see that how the air from windpipe goes to the bronchi, bronchioles and alveoli when we breathe in. Let us see. Bronchi, bronchioles and alveoli. The windpipe runs in the middle of the chest up to a short distance between the two lungs. After that, it gets divided into two bronchi. These two bronchi gets divided and subdivided into bronchioles. Like in a tree, the branches divide and subdivide, but at the end of these branches are present leaves. Similarly, in our lungs also, the bronchioles, at the end of these bronchioles are present alveolar sac. This alveolar sac has many alveoli. These alveoli are richly supplied with blood capillaries. The blood in the blood capillaries absorb the oxygen in the air and releases carbon dioxide to the alveoli. Then from the alveoli, the carbon dioxide goes to the bronchiole, then to the bronchi, then the windpipe, larynx, then pharynx, and then nasal cavity, and from the nose it is thrown out of the body when we breathe out. The inner wall of the windpipe bronchi bronchioles have very fine elongated structures, finger-like elongated structure called cilia. At times the food enters the windpipe when it is not closed properly by epiglottis. Then this ciliated epithelium pushes the unwanted particles present in the inhaled air, and thus we cough. Now let us see the outer structure of lungs. Lungs are a pair of spongy, elastic organs. They are present in the chest cavity and are protected by the rib cage, as you can see. The lungs are covered by two membranes called pleural membranes. As we have seen in the chloroplast, it is covered by two membranes. Similarly, lungs are also covered by double membrane, two membranes. But between these two membranes, there is present a fluid called pleural fluid. This pleural fluid increases the flexibility of lungs so that when we breathe in and breathe out, there is proper expansion and constriction of these lungs. The right lung is three-lobed, 1, 2, 3, and the left lung is two-lobed. Only two lobes are there, 1 and 2. Let us come to the exercise. First, let us see the syllabus. The syllabus of half-yearly exam. First chapter, plant life. Second chapter, the cell. And in third chapter, human body, digestive system and respiratory system. Respiratory system up to where I have taught. Let us see the exercises. A number, whatever we have completed, that questions we will see. Villi are present on the inner wall of the small intestine. Here will be small intestine. Villi are present in the small intestine. Liver secretes bile. Liver secretes what? Bile into the small intestine. Enzyme pepsin changes protein into proteoses and peptones. We have discussed this. Trachea divides into two branches in the lungs called bronchi. Just now we have seen. And true or false. Alimentary canal is also known as food canal. It is true. Food is mostly digested in the stomach. It is false, because food is mostly digested in the small intestine. Each alveolus is a group of alveolar sac. It is false. Each alveolar sac is a group of alveolus. Pleural fluid lubricates the lungs, making diffusion of gases easier. It is true, just now I have discussed pleural fluid lubricates the lungs, making diffusion of gases easier.